become information about the specific value of rooibos extract into our fermentation process. So what would I expect if rooibos are popular as food ingredients in a variety of products? For example, yogurt, bread, ready-to-drink iced teas and instant iced teas, these are just a few. Extracts are mainly produced from fermented rooibos, although we need to remember that rooibos fermentation is not a true microbiological fermentation, but mostly entails enzymatic and non-enzymatic oxidation processes. The production of food ingredient extracts from green rooibos has also gained popularity due to a much higher skeleton content. The skeleton is unique to rooibos and has been linked to many of the health benefits associated with rooibos, such as antioxidant activity, anti-mutagenic activity, and anti-diabetic activity. Due to the health benefits associated with the rooibos extracts, they are often used as nutraceutical ingredients. And nutraceutical just means that it's something that has health benefits beyond the basic nutritional value. And the term nutraceutical value then refers to many other parameters of food that are linked to its use as a nutraceutical. For example, the content of specific phenol compounds or antioxidant capacity. And the aim of the current study was to determine whether or how fermentation affects this nutritional value. Both green and fermented rooibos have previously been shown to have health benefits, and in some cases both were shown to be active, but some studies did not determine whether the one is better than the other. So this is mainly the case for increased plasma antioxidant capacity of the consumption of rooibos and fewer activity related to the esophageal cancer and cardioprotective activity. In terms of antioxidant capacity and antigenicity, the green rooibos extracts are generally superior to that of fermented rooibos extract. And anti-diabetic activity has thus for only been reported for green rooibos and anti-obesity activity only for fermented rooibos. So there's a lot of work still that can be done. So in this study, we make sure that differences we observed were only due to the fermentation process. We used 10 individual bushes that were subdivided compared to green and fermented. The plant material was dry boiled to produce green tea and in order to limit oxidation. Experimentation of the cut plant material mixed with water occurred at 38 degrees Celsius for 12 hours, followed by quite drying. All the plant material was milled before preparation of hot water extracts using a standard protocol simulating production of a starch extract in the industry. The extract was freeze dried and reconstituted as needed. So the two main things we measured were the phenolic composition, and we used an HPLC method to be simplified by Bielders et al., and also total antioxidant capacity in a few different assays with different mechanisms. DPPH, ABTs, and ORAC assays are based on scavenging of different types of free radicals, while the FRAP activity gives an indication of reducing ability. The total polyphenol content is also an indication of antioxidant capacity, as the assay is based on a redox reaction. So for the results, the total polyphenol content and total antioxidant capacity was significantly affected in the total polyphenol content and TS in the ORAC assay was least affected with about 14% and 16% reduction, while in the other assays reduction were between 24% and 31%. And now we've heard a couple of times about the asparagin, which is the unique compound in rooibos, and also the major compound in the green rooibos extracts, and that decreased substantially by 79% due to fermentation. Now, ether isoleucine and oriental only decreased in about 60%. interesting and very interesting perspective. And this is due to the oxidation of the styrofoam, which proceeds by oxidative coupling of the A and B rings to form two flavonoid derivatives. The diaphragm isoorientin is formed preferentially and can further be oxidated to isoorientin. And orientin can also then form from isoorientin via these immersive reactions. So that's why even that starts to decrease a lot, but its oxidation products are not decreased so much because they are formed from via oxidation of styrofoam. And similar results were found for notification and isodetection and detection. Detection indicating that isodetection and detection can also be formed from notification during the oxidation of notification. Some of the other compounds in the Rooibos extract, the only other two that was decreased on fermentation is two flood bonols, quercetin, and pollutin. And the other vinyl flavonol glycosides were not affected. Very interesting, this phenylpyruvic acid glucoside was also not affected by fermentation, and that is important implications as this contributes to the anti-diabetic activity of various extracts. So, in conclusion, the nutraceutical value of Rooibos food ingredient extracts are reduced by fermentation. Extensive losses of the diabetic shock cones, the stunting and the bacon occurs, along with the loss of reduction in gluten and small losses in some other compounds. These phenolic compound changes only resulted in a moderate reduction in total anaerobic capacity, indicating that the oxidation products of these compounds also have antioxidant activity. The green Rooibos extracts are therefore preferred for their high nutraceutical value, especially since many health benefits are attributed to asparagus. But on the other hand, the fermented Rooibos extracts are still valuable due to similar content of some of the health-promoting compounds, for example, the phenylpyruvic acid glucoside. And finally, I'd like to thank the funders and the tea company for supplying one of them.
Questions? Questions are...